Alright, now to part 3 of our nostalgic road back to old memories and better times. I mentioned before that I was at the end of the time of my BBS running the whole system on just one machine with OS 2. I used to, you know, start with like individual PCs, one PC for each node of the BBS, and all PCs were then connected in a token ring network, first via novel Lite, and then later via Lantastic, which was much better than the novel Lite, and I didn't want to use the real novel, because that would have been a little bit too much for my purposes. But then I got the powerful 486 100 megahertz PC with, I think, 8 megabytes at the beginning, and then upgraded it to... No, I got it with 8, then upgraded it right away to 16 and up to 32 megabytes, and had all 5 nodes of the BBS running on that machine. I needed some special COM ports, of course, because those were the slow points. Later on, I had also more DSL, ISCN. DSL is much, much newer. But it was running on this software. And it's a shame that it doesn't exist anymore. I remember a time when I did not remember seeing a blue screen. I saw it once in years while I was running OS 2. 24/7. Imagine that with Windows. Talking about Windows, that's Windows 98. Woo! Originals. German. I checked. I do not have a Windows 95 original. And I was thinking, and I said, like, I never owned one. As far as I got with Windows 95 is installing Microchip Windrec 95A beta. I didn't like Microsoft Windows 95 from the get-go. I saw a colleague struggling with it and having issues and blue screens and all that crap, what I didn't have with my OS 2 machine. I used it for a little bit when I had to on my second computer, but there I used a various copy of it. The first Windows 32 operating system that I actually got a license for was Windows 98, and I think it was even that particular disk. Okay, so that was a little bit going back into the operating system memory lane. I do not have the MS-DOS disk anymore, and I also never owned MS-DOS. The PC where we got the operating system with, the first PC my dad bought, was actually a Phobos, that was the chain computer, and they came with a digital research DOS, the DR DOS, in version, I think it was 7, while MS-DOS was still on version 5. It was way ahead, but it was not 100% compatible to MS-DOS, and it created issues, or it had issues, with running Windows 3.1 on it, especially the memory manager. This was done by Microsoft, those bastards, on purpose to get digital research out of the market, what they did then eventually. When it comes to the features of the digital research DOS and, you know, all the stuff, MS-DOS 6.22 almost closed up, you know, and catched up with what digital research had already done 3 years before, 4 years, something like that. They still didn't get the memory manager the way digital research got, you know, EMS, XMS, what, you know, it was doing it automatically, and was, you know, much more forgiving, and had a good install program and was explaining everything to you what Microsoft MS-DOS was also lagging. All right, enough about operating system. Oh, one thing I almost forgot was in the box. Just to show that it's not a knockoff or anything, that it's a real license. There you see it! It's a voucher for product justice, blah blah. Okay, and that's also somewhere in English. That's in German. Yeah, that's Dutch. Ah, Gutschein für Produkte, that's German. Somewhere I saw it anyway. Proof of entitlement. This is an IBM proof of entitlement referred to as proof. Okay? There it is. All right.